Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Wow, how exciting to see all of you here tonight. I am Reverend Michelle Kaminsky, and welcome to St. Luke's United Methodist Church. We are here for a treat, for a special organ concert by Owen Metz, who is in his first year of college at Oberlin, and he has also been a prodigy and student of our associate director of ministry and organist, Ken Mervine, and we are delighted to have this concert tonight. So welcome, sit back, relax, and enjoy, and I'm going to call Ken Mervine forward to share a little bit more with us. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. So thank you all for coming out in support of the music ministry here at St. Luke's, but very especially for Owen Metz. Had the privilege of meeting Owen several years ago when he came and wanted to study organ, and said, great, that's good. Being a teacher, it's always wonderful to have a student come to you who is not only gifted and talented, but motivated, bright, and I'd say highly intrinsically motivated. You know, you tell a student what you like them to do, and they go off and they turn on the garden hose of education and information, and his is more like a fire hose. It's been a joy and a privilege to work with him and see him attain great heights. He's got some wonderful repertoire for it to share with you this evening, and some of which organists don't get until they're pursuing a master's degree or beyond even. So I'll just tell you the thanks again for being here. The first piece on the program is actually by French composer Charles-Marie Vidor. You can go ahead and click on the QR code and you'll see the program. I will say this, tomorrow actually is the 153rd anniversary of Vidor accepting the post of Saint-Sulpice in Paris, which he held until 1937 when he passed away. Anyway, this is the Allegro from Symphony No. 6. And I will tell you now, fasten your seatbelts. So.
Thank you. Thank you. Before I begin, I just want to give a huge thank you to the St. Luke's community who've been so supportive throughout my whole journey with music, especially the clergy team with Michelle and Liza, and then the music ministry with Jim, Kay, and Chris. And most especially today, specifically Ken Fong in the tech booth has been wonderful, and then as well Ken Mervine, who's been just a blessing this whole time and has been super instrumental in helping me get to where I am now. So a round of applause for them. So that first movement was of the Allegro from Vidor's sixth organ symphony. It chronologically follows the Toccata from the fifth symphony, which is by far his most famous piece and one of the big kind of cornerstones of the organ repertoire. And as Ken mentioned, Vidor was the organist at Saint-Sulpice in Paris, which is kind of the greatest instrument in France. It was the legendary organ builder Aristide Cavaillé-Cole. It was his greatest instrument, 100 stops, so 100 of those things. It's absolutely massive. There's five manuals or five keyboards. It's a huge instrument. And Vidor was also just extremely accomplished. He worked for over 60 years at Saint-Sulpice, and he taught at the Paris Conservatoire both as an organist and as a composition teacher, and you can kind of see both of those things in that piece of a lot of organ technique and a lot of composition stuff, which is cool. The next piece is quite a change. It's much quieter. It's a piece entitled Soliloquy by David Conti, who was a contemporary composer. And this piece was composed in 1996 in honor of the Cleveland organ builder Chick Holtkamp. So kind of going back to Oberlin, we have several Holtkamp instruments there, so it's kind of in honor of him and his name. It's a very unique melody. It's very disjunct. There's a lot of leaps, but it's still super lyrical and beautiful. And the harmony is really cool with the chords. A lot of them are built in fourths as opposed to thirds, which are traditional. So it has a little bit of a different feeling than you might feel in a normal piece. So this is Soliloquy.
Thank you.
instruments. The next three pieces, actually, are just very staples in organ music for the fact they're written by J.S. Bach, who is probably the greatest organist of all time. Just the accounts of him playing and improvising are just absolutely incredible. And he also was a very prominent teacher during his day. So these trio sonatas, I'll be playing the one in C minor, BWV 526. And these were written as teaching pieces for his eldest son, Wilhelm Friedemann. So the trio sonata, and then there's trio, which means there's three completely independent voices. So there'll be one in the right hand, one in the left hand, and then one in the pedal. So it's interesting, you can listen for independent voices or kind of how they all mesh together. And they're wonderful pieces. Obviously, they're notorious in the organ repertoire, one for just how great they are as a composition, but they're also quite difficult because you have so much to keep track of, which makes them really great pieces to learn with. So this is the trio sonata in C minor.
Thank you.
So the next part of the program, I actually forgot to put on the physical program. So we'll be doing a hymn sing to the tune of Saint Anne, which is a wonderful hymn written in 1708 by William Croft. The namesake of Saint Anne comes from the church that he played at, Saint Anne in England. But I also like to think of it as an acknowledgement to my mother, who was a saint, so Saint Anne. So the text that you will sing is Our God, O Help in Ages Past, and that was written by Isaac Watts, who wrote several other texts to hymns. And you might notice that there's a similar title between this and the fugue that I will be playing next, with both having Saint Anne, and that's because they share a very similar opening line. They likely didn't collaborate or hear the other's pieces before they wrote it, but they're extremely similar. So I'll play both for you. So this is the opening to the hymn. And then the fugue opens like this. So it's the same set of notes, just in a different with a different rhythm. So the nickname for the fugue then has become Saint Anne. So we will sing six verses of this hymn. I will give it's quick, Mom, don't roll your eyes. It's a quick hymn. It's only 8 bars per verse. So there'll be a 1 stanza introduction, and then there'll be an interlude before the 6th verse.
Thank you.
think that was awesome. You guys sounded great. So the next piece then kind of continues with that. This is Bach's Prelude in E-flat major, nicknamed St. Anne, BWV 552. So this piece is from the Klavierübung 3. Bach wrote 4 Klavierübungs. This is the third one, which is for organ. It's also known as the German organ mass. And so it's like an hour and a half, basically, of straight chorales and stuff. So that can be interesting. If you're interested, I would encourage listening to it. But this prelude and fugue, instead of, it actually opens and closes it. It sandwiches it. So you'll play the prelude before, and then once you finish with all 20-something chorale settings, you will play the fugue. It's one of Bach's longest preludes and fugues, but it's also one of his best by far. And it also kind of shows just how genius he was as a composer. Bach never left Germany during his lifetime, yet for the prelude, the opening theme is a French overture, and there's a second theme, which is an Italian concerto, and the third theme is a German fugue. So all these different nationalities and composing styles have really kind of come together into one work. And then also, Bach was a devout Lutheran, and you might remember this is the German organ mass, so that kind of represents the Trinity of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You have 3 distinct sections within the piece. And the fugue also continues that. It's a triple fugue. There are 3 different subjects throughout, which also reinforce the Trinity. And then you might be wondering what a fugue is. It's actually a great quote from Yo-Yo Ma in the Netflix movie Glass Onion. If you haven't seen it, it's a great movie. But he says, a fugue is a beautiful musical puzzle based on just one tune. And when you layer this tune on top of itself, it starts to change and develops and turns into a beautiful new structure. So Bach really takes this even a step farther. Instead of having one idea, he has 3 that he kind of weaves in together, which is really impressive. So the first section of the fugue is like a chorale. The second is just with the keyboards, there's no feet, which is surprisingly the hardest section out of all of the 3. And it's very light. And the third section is like a Baroque dance or a jigue. So it's a wonderful piece. So I hope you enjoy Bach's Prelude and Fugue in E-flat. This next piece is also by Bach. It's the last Bach piece in the program, and this is the kind of the third type of piece that Bach wrote for organ. You already heard a trio sonata and a prelude and fugue, and this is a chorale prelude. So traditionally before a hymn, the organist would play like a whole setting of the tune they would sing, and then it would come into the hymn. So this specific chorale is Nun komm der Heidenheiland, which roughly translates to Now Come, Savior of the Non-Believers. This is an Advent hymn, so kind of in the preparation for Christ. So that's kind of where the title comes from, of waiting for Jesus to save our sins, I guess. This is part of the 18 Great or Leipzig chorales, which are all wonderful. And then for, in the English text, if you look in the hymnal, is Savior of the Nations Come, is the kind of traditional hymn that we would sing in an American church today. So this is an ornamented melody setting. So I will play just the tune that it's based off of, and then in the reed stop, the kind of like, I don't know, you'll know which one it is, I guess. So that will be kind of playing the same melody I played at the beginning, but it'll be adding decorations and, you know, little scales or trills or different things to make the melody a little bit more interesting. This is Nun komm der Heidenheiland, BWV 659.
Thank you.
And then this final piece will be the final piece of the program. So I just want to thank you so much to everyone who came. It's great to see so many people supporting organ music. It's somewhat of a dying breed, so it's great to see that there's people still interested. also, just the support of the St. Luke's community, the Performing Arts Division, and especially Ken, who's just been incredible of getting practice time and giving me advice and how to improve all my playing and stuff. So can we give Ken a round of applause? And additionally, we will have a reception in the fellowship hall just out back at the end. There's cookies and water if you're interested. I know it's almost dinner time, but have a cookie or two. So the final piece is one that you may know the tune that it's based on, but maybe not the piece. It's Carillon de Westminster by Louis Vierne. And Louis Vierne was the organist at Notre Dame from 1900 to 1937. And what's most impressive about that is that he was blind. He could see very vaguely, but really not at all. So he was an incredible organist, an incredible improviser. He actually died on the organ bench at Notre Dame giving a recital. He finished the program and was improvising afterwards. He hit a low E on the pedal board and just kind of slumped onto the keyboard. So then there's just a low E ringing in Notre Dame. So he got his wish of dying on the bench at Notre Dame. So it's quite a unique story. So this piece is based on the theme from the Palace of Westminster's clock tower. Ironically, it's not the original melody. It's slightly different than the original. We don't really know why. It could have been that Vierne deliberately changed it. It could have been incorrectly transcribed, or because he heard it from an associate that he could have just, the associate could have like said it or sung it wrong, so then that's what he knew. So ironically, it's his most popular piece and the tune isn't right. But nonetheless, it's still a great piece, so I hope you enjoy Carillon de Westminster.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming. Enjoy the cookies and drive safe home.